everyone. We have exciting news for SAP UI5. There's a new feature allowing you to use evergreen Bootstrap URLs for your projects. You can now bootstrap your projects with a URL that specifies a major and minor version of SAP UI5 you want to use, but doesn't specify a patch level. You will automatically profit from patches, and the underlying SAP UI5 runtime will be kept up to date. The patch level independent Bootstrap works for long-term maintenance versions of SAP UI5 and requires you to have control over the Bootstrap script tag. Check out Peter's blog post to get all the details.
In this latest blog post, SAP champion Michael Keller and I discuss why we got started with ABAP and why you should too. We talked briefly on our experiences with ABAP, and Michael shared his expertise and why he hearts ABAP. Check out the interview in the description below. Speaking of ABAP, in the latest 2 minute of ABAP video, I discussed some key differences between the on-premise and the cloud versions of ABAP. Don't forget to check that out as well.
The new version of the mobile development kit client with 6.2 is out now. With the new version, a whole set of new features is available to you, including new UI enhancements like SAP Fiori Horizon Visual Theme, a new design for the object table multi-select mode on Android, and support for the timeline preview and timeline control. We also got API and syntax enhancements for select all and deselect all functionality in the object table multi-select mode, new trace level for the log actions and log APIs, dynamic page metadata support for the tabs control, and improved OData image caching. The Business Application Studio Editor got a great MDK web preview runtime, and you can connect to the mobile services Neo landscape as well. For a full overview of all new features and improvements, check out Chitendra Kansal's blog post on blogs.sap.com.
The SAP HANA Database Explorer for Visual Studio Code extension has recently been updated to version 1.5. The most major new addition to this extension is support for ARM architecture. Now, this is done by the extension dynamically switching internally between the @SAP HANA client or the HDB module, depending upon which architecture it can see that it's running on. And this most importantly means that this extension is now supported on Apple M1 chips and devices that use those chips. So I'm sure many Mac users with newer laptops would welcome that addition. We also see improvements to the SQL console. We now have the ability to return multiple result sets from a single query. You can also configure a maximum result set size for a single query. And there are new autosave and loss protection features in the console as well. And finally, the database list has seen several improvements to make the user experience more like the browser-based Database Explorer. And in particular, this brings improved error messages. So be sure to try out the Database Explorer if you're a Visual Studio Code user, and let us know what you think in the comments below.
There are more innovations coming our way in SAP's Cloud Application Programming Model, CAP. Described in the CAP Hire documentation at cap.cloud.sap, there's a new experimental feature, Simple Field Extensibility. Note that this is fully experimental at this stage and is purely available for feedback and testing purposes. There's a new aspect called Extensible, and this provides the plumbing that's needed for this feature, which you can turn on in your Node.js package.json by introducing a new property, Extensibility. Check out all the details for this new experimental feature in the CAP Hire documentation, the cookbook section at cap.cloud.sap.